Welcome to our lesson on plotting inequalities on a grid. So when we plot inequalities on a grid, we have different symbols. We have the greater than and the less than symbol, and we have the greater than or equal to and the less than or equal to symbol. For the top two, when it can be greater than or less than, we use a dashed line, and when it can be greater than or equal to or less than or equal to, we use a full line. So we have the inequality, x is greater than 3. And you can see at this point here, x is equal to 3. And anywhere along this line, the y values will change, but the x value will always be 3. And as we go to the right, you can see in this blue section, we have when x is 4 and when x is 5. So as we go to the right, the inequality is x is greater than 3. Greater than because it is a dashed line, which you can see here. So this inequality matches to this region. For the next one, when x is less than or equal to negative 3, well, here we have negative 3 for x. Again, the y value changes, but x is always at negative 3. And because we're going to the left now, you can see that the x values are decreasing. So this region is defined by x is less than or equal to negative 3, which is this one here and for this region. For our third inequality, y is less than negative 3. Well, here is when y is negative 3. This time the x values change, but the y is always negative 3. And because it is a dashed line, and the numbers are getting smaller in that coloured region, the inequality is y is less than negative 3. Less than because the numbers are getting smaller and the line is dashed. So this inequality matches with this region. And finally, when y is greater than or equal to 3, this is when y is equal to 3. And because we're going up, the numbers are getting bigger. So this is the inequality y is greater than or equal to 3. And it can be equal to because we have a full line here. So this inequality matches with this region. Okay, let's try some more questions. So here we have a grid with x and y. Would you like to try to plot these three inequalities on this grid? You can pause the video and resume it when you're ready. So for question A, we have x is greater than 2. Well, this is when x is equal to 2 anywhere along this vertical line. Again, the y values change, but x is always 2. And because it has to be greater than, we're going to use a dashed line because it cannot be equal to. And we're going to our right where the numbers get bigger. So this would be the inequality x is greater than 2. And for question B, y is less than 1. Well, here is the point where y is 1, anywhere along this line. And because it is less than 1, we're going vertically downwards. And it cannot be equal to, so it is a dashed line, which we can shade in here. We can check this works by picking any value in this region. Here, for instance, you can see y is negative 2, and negative 2 is less than 1. So anywhere in this green region, this is true. And for question C, x is less than or equal to 1. Well, this is when x is equal to 1, and because it is less than, we're going in this direction where the numbers get smaller. But it can be equal to, as you can see here. So it is a full line going in this direction, where x is less than or equal to 1. Okay, do you want to try and plot the inequalities of D and E? You can pause the video and resume it when you're ready. So for question D, y is greater than or equal to 0? Well, here is the line y is equal to 0 along the x-axis, and because it is greater than, all of these values of y's make the statement true. So we can shade in this region and this line. And this is a full line because it can be equal to it. Okay, and for question E. Now, to plot the inequality y is less than x, I'm going to use the equation y is equal to x to understand where the line goes. And you can see that when y is equal to 1, x will be equal to 1, which is here. When x equals 2, y equals 2. So we have a diagonal line shown by these points. And because it is not equal to it, it will be a dashed line through these points. And this is y is less than x. So the y values must be less than the x values. So this is below the line. And again, we can check this works. We'll look at this point here where x is 1 and y is negative 2. We'll put them into this inequality where y, which is negative 2, is that less than the x, which is 1? Yes, it is. And we can make doubly sure by picking a point which shouldn't be true, where x is negative 2 and when y is positive 2. We'll put these into the inequality. Y, which is 2, should not be less than x, which is negative 2. And you can see this does not work. So this is the correct region for y is less than x. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope you found that useful. Thanks again, and take care.